learn about your users' interactions in your app without actually tracking them. Hey, this is Flo, and in this video I will teach you how to integrate TelemetryDeck into your own apps. First of all, of course, you have to create an account on the TelemetryDeck website. For that, I would super appreciate it if you use the link in the video description, because that way both you and I get 100,000 free signals for our app. Alright, so the first step is on the TelemetryDeck dashboard on the website, we need to create a new app. So just hit that Create New App button, then give it a name. So in my case, it will be called TD Test for TelemetryDeck Test. In your case, this is just your app's regular name, and then you hit Create App. Next, we need to grab the SDK URL. So let's hit up this link here, and then we will get redirected to the Swift client on GitHub. Let's just copy the URL, so click on code, and then click on that little copy icon over here. And then we can already go back to our Xcode project. I've just prepared a blank app called TD Test, TelemetryDeck Test. Let's add the package to our app. So let's go to Frameworks, Libraries, and Embedded Content, click the plus and say Add Package Dependency. I usually like to let it load here for a second and then just paste the URL into the search bar and hit Add Package. Add Package again. Next, we need to initialize the framework. So for that, we can just copy over this little code snippet here, go back into our SwiftUI app, let me zoom in for you, and then we can just create an initializer here for our app struct, and in there just paste everything. Of course, we have to import telemetry client, just like that. Now we need our app identifier. To get that, we need to go back into the web dashboard and copy our app identifier at the bottom here, and then just paste it in this little app ID string over here. That's already everything that you need to do to initialize TelemetryDeck. Next up, of course, you want to send signals and log user interactions. So for that, let's go into the content view and let's replace this text with a button saying send signal. Let's also give this quite a bit of padding because I'm running a macOS target here, and otherwise the window would be quite small. And let's also give the window a frame of 200 by 200. You of course don't need to do this in your actual app. And now to send a signal, you just import telemetry client, and then you can just say telemetry manager dot send. And there are a few different overloads. The first one is just sending a signal with a string identifier. And the second one would be to also perhaps include a user identifier in some, for example, if your users have to log into your app, then you might want to add that user identifier to the signal. And then you can also add additional payload options, which is just a dictionary of string to string. These are optional. So let's just do the easiest thing, and that would be send signal button pressed, for example. Just give this a nice readable name that you can then understand in your dashboard and your telemetry viewer app. Okay, let me run this app, click the button, and then show you what's happening in the dashboard. Okay, so the app is now running. Apparently the frame that I specified for the window is a bit too small, but I don't think that's an issue. So now I can just hit the send signal button here. You might see an error in the console saying that no user ID could be created, which is no problem because we don't need that actually. Let us instead have a look at the dashboard and see if that signal actually went through. So I can't see the signal right now, and that's probably because it just takes a bit until it's visible. But one very important switch that you have to take into consideration is to activate the test mode. That way, debug signals, so when you're launching an app in debug mode, will get displayed here. While we are waiting for the signal to arrive, let's do one more step that I always like to do when working with external dependencies, and that's abstracting them behind some service layer or something like that. So for that, let's create a new file and let's call it logging manager. And in here, we can then import telemetry client, and then either create a global function or a class with a shared instance, with a static function, something that's an abstraction between your view and the telemetry client. So in my case, I will just create a class called Logging Manager, give this a static let shared equals a logging manager, so basically a singleton, and then make sure this can't be initialized. We had a private init. And next, let's just create a wrapper function here for our telemetry manager.send. So let's just call this function log. It will take in a signal which is of type string, and then optionally also a dictionary of values. So let's call this values, and it's just a dictionary of string to string. By default, it will just be empty. And then this function internally just calls telemetry manager.send our signal. Oops. For no user. This app doesn't have any user, so really doesn't matter. If your app has user IDs, then you might want to add them as well. And then let's also pass in all of the values here. Now this creates just a layer of abstraction. So if in any case you want to change which framework you're using, so if you don't want to use TelemetryDeck anymore, or if their API changes and you don't want to have to update it in every single place that you were logging something, I think having an abstraction layer like this is just a very easy win. And then of course, let's use that abstraction layer so we can remove our import from our content view, remove this line, let's actually copy the string here. And instead we can say logging manager dot shared dot log that signal. And then internally that will just call the same function as before, our telemetry manager dot send signal function. Okay, now you can see that the signal also arrived, and it was actually pretty quick. I just made a little mistake because I didn't add the outgoing connections entitlement to the app sandbox because I'm running a macOS app here, so it just couldn't connect to the server. That's my bad. I just tried it again, and this time pressing the button basically instantly generated a signal that I could view in the web dashboard. As you can see right here, it's pretty quick. So if you want to try out TelemetryDeck yourself, feel free to use the referral link that's at the top of the video description. In this video, you learned about the TelemetryDeck platform and SDK and how you can use it to understand how your users use your apps. Subscribe to the channel if you want to learn even more about iOS and macOS development. That's it. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.